Recording.
Well, here we go, another one. And I'm going to let Ben cover Aaron first.
All right, so this is Ben and Kevin. Kevin is actually playing on this one on the right-hand side. Aaron, first time playing in our tournament. New, he's actually from... Where is he from?
I don't know.
Pretty far down south. They were in... Him and his wife... His wife wanted to go to IKEA, so he got dropped off to play the tournament while she was IKEA-ing it up. Okay, so he's playing Outer Rim Smuggler, the Millennium Falcon, which is a crazy thing. I've never seen anybody play it because the hit dice dropped two. But because of that, he can play three ships on this build. He's playing with Bistan, which turns a hit to a crit. Engine upgrade, which gives him the boost maneuver, and the Millennium Falcon title, which
allows him an evade action.
Gives him the evade action.
Jake Farrell, you can spend the focus token to do a boost or a barrel roll. Push the limit, so he's going to use push the limit to take an evade to do a barrel roll or a boost. He has Predator, which allows you to re-roll one dice.
Look at this.
It's funny. We're talking
about the stat line of the normal Falcon.
Uh-huh.
He loses two hull and a shield.
Two hull, as well a shield, as an attack dice. But he's able to run three ships with it, so that's pretty powerful. He just needs to play the outer game, which he does pretty well with this guy. Millennium Falcon, unlike other ones, wants to directly engage. This guy, because it's reduced, he wants to stay on the outside and do range two, range three hits. Don't get in close, which he does a really good job of doing. All right, so then Jake Farrell, you can spend a token to do a boost or barrel roll. Push the limit, which allows you to do an extra action for a stress. If you get a stress, Predator, which allows you to reroll one dice. Attack or defense or both?
With Predator?
Predator. It's just attack, right?
I think it's just attack.
Okay. If your pilot skill is two or less, you get to reroll two.
Two dice.
Test pilot,
the guy that you're shooting at.
Test pilot allows you to have two elite pilot talents. That's why he's able to do push the limit and Predator. And the... Chart and refit, which does a minus two. So he's reducing his points like crazy here. Then he's playing Wedge, which... is it anyone he's attacking?
Whoever he shoots at gets... shoots, gets a reduced agility.
Okay, so if the person shoots first, they don't get a reduced agility.
No. When Wedge shoots.
If
Wedge shoots at IG-88A, he only gets two green dice instead of three.
He shoots. Okay. You reduce the agility of the ship he's firing at by one. BB-8, which is all green... all green movements, you get a free barrel roll action, which means you get to move like crazy. And proton torpedoes, it's a four dice range,
two to three,
and you get to change one eye to a crit for proton torpedoes, which is pretty powerful.
Yep,
though it's a one shot thing. All right, so Kevin, what are you running?
I'm running IG-88A, which pilot ability
on Dengar. What is the Dengar base ability?
No, that's here? On.
Oh, IG-88A. I'm sorry. I saw IG-88D down on Dengar. So go ahead.
Yes.
Go ahead.
So I got one of the Brobot sitting on in its typical aggressor.
Dude, you got Brobot.
Anyway, he's he has the ability when he destroys an enemy ship to regain a shield. And the IG-2000 title says anybody else with another IG pilot or IG-88D gets the same ability.
Oh, so he's spreading it around. Well, that's perfect for scum and villainy. That means when you destroy something, you scavenge the shit out of the debris and increase it. That's really
okay.
Smart. Go ahead.
So both of my ships have pushed the limit.
That's your favorite card, I think. Why don't you marry that card? You love it so much. Sorry, go ahead. It's a good card. Like, just like with mine, with what's it called? The experience,
expertise.
The expertise. What is it? Experience? I love expertise. Go ahead. All right.
IG-88 also has auto thrusters because why the heck not? And
which means if they're outside of your firing arc and they attack you, you get an extra defense dice.
Yeah,
you get an extra defense dice. You get to do.
I get to change a blank to an evade. He's already got 3 defense dice.
Oh, that makes it really beefy then.
So, and he gets electronic baffles.
During this game, during this tournament, we didn't play each other, so I don't know how this plays against my.
No.
Okay, so you get electronic baffles, which allows you to spend a.
Take a damage. To remove a stress, or to not take a stress.
Oh, so with push the limit, you can do some crazy stuff. And you've got 4 shield too.
I end up doing with it is, if I do a K or a sloop, and turn around, all electronic baffles still take my actions
and push the limit and get a second action. Oh,
that's so then
evil.
I get behind them, facing toward them, and push the limit to get all my dice mods.
Surprise, evilness.
Surprise.
All right, Dengar.
Dengar has IG-80D, which gives him the ability of A.
Uh-huh.
And he has push the limit as well. He has feedback array, which didn't come into play the entire freaking tournament.
Which does what?
Allows me, instead of taking my attack, to do a damage to someone at range 1.
Oh, so it's like bumping without bumping. Bumping long range.
But it does damage to me and an ion token as well.
Oh.
But, you know, I guess like an A-Wing or something I thought might be useful.
Yeah, I'd switch that out for something. Go ahead. What's it? Punishing one?
R5-B11.
Okay. R5-B11. Okay.
Which is the... it allows me to spend a target lock on a ship to have them reroll as many of their defense dice as I want them to.
Ah, shenanigans.
Yes.
All right, punishing one?
Punishing one ups my attack from 2 to 3.
Oh,
it's a title card. It's also unique, so you can only run one in a squad. And then I took extra munitions, because I don't have a second copy of Seismic.
So what does extra munitions do?
Gives an extra token to munitions.
Oh, so then that's why you have the Seismic.
Seismic torpedoes.
So you want to try to blow up some asteroids. But, you know, I've seen seismic torpedoes on several builds and played against them, but nobody ever ended up using them. Did you end up using them this time on this one?
Well, there's been changes I've made to this build because of that.
Okay.
Now,
what is the Dengar title card? Is that the shoot back? The
yes.
The shoot back nastiness thing?
Yeah, he gets a revenge attack.
Revenge attack if you're in his firing arc?
If you shoot him while you're in his arc.
Okay. I thought it was just in general, but you have to be in arc?
Yes.
All right. So let's see what's going on here. The spread, he's moving his guys. He's trying to do the Outer Rim Smuggler at longer range. And what are you doing? You're still in the back with Dengar. Are you trying to split your attacks? Or are you going at... What's your thoughts here? I would go after, because of the only one attack dice for Outer Rim Smuggler, I would be beating the hell out of that thing.
That's what I was going for.
Okay.
You see the ball...
Now, that being said, in the final match, I actually play Austin. Aston? What's his name?
Aaron.
I'm sorry. I can't see that far. The laptop's far away from me. I actually kill his other 2 ships, and I leave the big one for last, because it's berserk.
Well, if I remember correct, he did some nasty blocking with the Outer Rim Smuggler.
Oh, he did? Oh, okay.
He ended up keeping me on an asteroid. I did not... I'm going to admit, this is not a game to learn how to fly these ships.
Oh, is this your first time playing it?
No. It's not the first time I played, but I made some bad decisions, and I got blocked, which made some bad decisions horrible.
Yeah, I got to remember that. If someone's on an asteroid, try to block them and keep them on that asteroid, because that would be really powerful. That's 2 rounds on an asteroid of no shooting.
He made a lot of value out of the Outer Rim Smuggler.
See, that's...
As a blocker.
Well... Millennium Falcon and 2 ships? That's kind of crazy.
It's a large base ship. So a large base makes for an awfully good blocker at PS1. I mean, there's nothing that's going to get under your PS without taking a critical card.
Oh my gosh, 4 defense? What's that? So who's shooting who? Who's zooming who?
I think that's when he shot at me.
Range 3?
Yeah, I did my typical...
For IG-88 range... No, I think you're blocked, right? What's going on here?
No, he shot at IG.
Okay.
and I was showing him auto thrusters.
I think that's what I was showing him.
No, he was shooting at... What the heck was I showing him? Oh, I showed him punishing one because I roll three dice to attack his... I think it was his A-wing. That
also, if you'll notice in the lower right-hand corner, R2-D2 is on Aaron's side, so he has initiative. That's our new indicator. Thank you, R2. Try to increase his shields.
You know that's the origin of his crew card ability, right?
Yeah, I know. It's great. He increases the shields. Yeah. It's hilarious. Yeah, if you guys get a chance to see it on YouTube, somebody, on all the scenes R2-D2 is in, instead of doing his bloops and bleeps, some guy with a British accent actually does dialogue and goes back and forth with C-3PO. And it is hilarious, because a lot of times you don't know what R2 is saying. How you know what R2 is saying is C-3PO repeats it or reacts to what he's saying. Yep. So R2-D2 actually says it. He's a snarky little bot.
Yeah, right.
He has actually got a wicked tongue if he could actually speak.
Oh, come on. You know who made him?
Yeah.
Anakin.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Yeah.
Anakin built him.
Yeah, that's true. But Anakin is a little bitch, but he's not that snarky.
Did you see him in the Clone Wars?
Yeah, but still.
Yeah, he is.
He's a little bitch. I'm sorry. That would be an interesting thing, to see an Anakin card.
Yeah.
Right? In this game, we haven't seen that.
I don't know if they're going to do it. I mean, there's been a bunch of people, like, really want to see, like, Anakin and Obi-Wan in their
And Yoda.
And Yoda.
And Count Dooku. Is Count Dooku anywhere?
No.
Well, there's a bunch of ones from the first three movies.
Well, supposedly...
No, just don't give me a Jar Jar card. I'm going to burn it on camera.
Oh, come on. Jar Jar Binks in a Y-Wing? Why not?
Mister, I make you re-roll.
Does Jar Jar have to do a random barrel roll and reduce all damage to zero?
Mister, I crash your Senate. See, that's the redeeming thing. I really hated Jar Jar, but he was the one who suggested it. I mean, he was hated for a reason. They embraced it. Right?
Didn't you know he was a Sith Lord?
He's not a Sith Lord. Like, my left testicle's a Sith Lord. Jesus.
Come on, he started the whole war.
Well, he did, and that's... I don't know if that was planned. I think it was a reaction to how hated he was during the first... with that first movie, is they decided, fine, he's hated. Let's make him be the one to start the war. Misa think I'm smart, doing the right thing. Misa calls the Clone Wars. It's so derogatory to Jamaicans, right? I mean, yeah. It is really bad. Oh, here we go. I got it. He's a Jamaican jerk.
That's what he is. He's a Jamaican jerk.
All right, back to X-Wing. Sorry about the side note. Nothing's really happening. Kevin's just flying over asteroids and crap. That's all that's happening.
No, I'm just evading all of his shots. That's what I'm doing.
Oh, good rolling.
And he evaded all of my shots, too, all right. Somehow.
So you're nonplussed.
Yeah, so it was a big bunch of nothing that round.
So did you all fly with asteroids? Oh, I see the finger. Yeah, you all asteroids.
I had little bitty asteroids. The other great big ones.
So what are your feelings, asteroids versus debris? You always seem to do asteroids, right? But you do the little ones, right?
With this list, I do the smallest asteroids.
Oh, but because, well, I guess with this list, if you're doing the seismic torpedoes, you want more asteroids out there to blow things up.
I wouldn't mind well, that works with debris as well.
Oh, it works. Oh, okay.
It says
then,
obstacle.
Then why did you...
Because I fly like crap with these guys, and I'm trying to get better with them.
Oh, okay.
I may switch to running larger asteroids with this squad when I get better at flying the stupid thing.
All right.
But one thing I'm trying to do by flying smaller asteroids, and sometimes I have used it in matches, and I will continue to, is using the seismic torpedoes to clear out asteroids so Dengar has more room to do barrel rolls.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Dengar,
a large ship doing a barrel is a crazy, crazy maneuver because you can really screw with people. Oh, Dengar's not an arc. Surprise! Dengar is an arc!
Surprise! He's not in your arc anymore.
Exactly.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Large ship barrel roll. How is that a thing? It should only be a barrel roll to the left, right?
That would be funny.
It should only be a left side barrel roll, I would say.
But it can barrel roll both ways, which is actually a really good maneuver.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you find yourself wanting
to... Ouch. Here you go. Let's go through the asteroid.
Well, whee! I don't think I had a whole lot of choice there.
No, you didn't. You see, that's the thing with large ships, too. When you're doing turns, try to do a one. Because two is really going to put you farther forward than you think it's going to
be. I just wanted to clear the asteroid, which I barely did.
I'm talking about the move before this. Shouldn't have been right in front. But that ended up being really good for the Falcon, but you're both at range one, but still.
Well, it's four dice for me and three for him. Don't get actions, which is what really sucked there.
Yeah. But you didn't take a damage, so there you go.
No.
All right, you're getting serious. Both hands are on the table. Good thing you don't have sweaty palms, otherwise it'd be a stinky board. Okay, four forward.
That's three forward.
Three forward? Three forward.
Yeah.
Ooh, that still puts him in range one. I wonder where you're going to move. I think you're going to do a two easy, is my prediction, to the left. We'll see. Toward the Falcone. Falcone.
Did I do two? Yeah, I almost never do a three. Well, yeah, I almost never do a three if I don't have unhinged Astromech. And honestly, R4B11... has done more work for me than unhinged.
Really?
So. Yeah, being able to make people re-roll dice is just awesome.
Yeah. It just makes you feel good. You're an evil, evil person. Sorry, no, that's
good. It lets me push damage, sure.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's sometimes when you have high agility ships, pushing damage through is a kind of a problem.
Yeah, push it.
Push it, push it real good.
So, a little bit on the side here. I don't know if you've heard this rumor. I wonder if it's true, but I've heard the young Han Solo movie is a Western themed. Even though it's in space, it's supposed to have Western overtones to it, which I think would be awesome if they can pull it off. But we'll see. I'm looking forward to seeing. I'm hoping we'll see the first encounter between Han and Chewie.
Heck yeah.
That would be amazing. The second thing, I think the relationship between Han and Lando, the give and take, I think they're going to be snarky. They're going to be digging at each other. I think it's going to be a really good little bromance thing. I can't wait to see that.
Have you seen Lando in Rebels?
No, I haven't actually watched any of the cartoons.
Oh my God. Harrison Dula and Lando have a problem with each other.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. I guess I need to get caught up and watch it because I heard Rebels next season's the last season. Is this what someone said?
I hope not.
Okay. I need to get caught up. I haven't.
Here's where my bad time kicks in.
See, I said too easy. You did too hard. Didn't you listen to me? Oh, I'm sorry. This is a week later.
I should have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I haven't watched any of the cartoon ones. I've got so much other Netflix addiction. I don't know about you guys out there, but every time I talk to somebody, they tell me of another show that I have to watch. To stop everything now, watch this show! My parents, House of Cards! House of Cards! You know, it's just show after show and season after season. I think I need to quit my job and just do Netflix binge watch reviews. And see if I can make money off that. No one can make
money. Oh, Dengar took a damage from the rock.
Asteroid. Oh. All right.
The first damage of the game was Dengar running into the stupid little asteroid I put there.
Wait. It's the finger asteroid, too. You got fingered. Freddy got fingered.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Is that the finger or the mustache?
I think it's the finger popped your cherry.
No, no, no. The finger's over here. This is the mustache. Oh,
the mustache. You had a mustache ride.
Oh. That was not a good ride.
No, it wasn't. Ouchies. So, do you run Scum a lot, right? I don't run Scum at all. I don't even own a Scum ship.
I like them. I mean, they get shenanigans.
Well, I mean, they've been showed they can win the world, so I guess they're pretty powerful, but I think it takes a little bit more intelligence to run some of the Scum stuff, because every time I've been against the Scum guy, they've just run really poorly. I don't know. Maybe it's the people I'm playing against.
Quite possibly.
Well, except that one... What's that one with the houndstooth that you get to take a card away from somebody?
Boba Fett?
Is it Boba Fett that if he hits...
Boba Fett's the crew card. Yeah, if he does a crit, he can take a card off.
Oh, see, someone... I may play it just to do that, because...
I wish I had Boba Fett to have... I wish I had room to stick Boba Fett in this list.
Because if Boba Fett... If you could Boba Fett Palpatine... Oh, my God, that would hurt so bad!
People have done it.
Oh, I know.
That's your answer to Palpatine.
There you go, Boba Fett.
That's actually one of the tricks triple jump masters will do, is one of them will be running Boba Fett and he'll try to get a crit in.
Oh.
Clear off Palpatine before he does a lot of work.
Are there any Scum cards that allow you to like switch things to crits or choose a dice? Or they're not like that. That's mainly Imperial.
Yeah, no, that's more Imperial, but there is
this tech is Rebel.
Yeah.
Is there a Bistech alternative on Scum? Oh, if there ever is, then people should just be running Boba Fett all the time.
There's some generic ones.
That can do it, right?
Calculation can change an eyeball to a crit.
Well, someone needs... I may try to do my first Scum build that needs to be Boba Fett with calculation. And I need to strip people naked of their cards. It doesn't help with a TIE Swarm, though.
No, it doesn't. No, it really doesn't. Yeah, I've had a lot of people talking about locally, just they think swarms are really coming back.
Really?
Well, some of the things that ran them out of the meta
have
been nerfed.
Oh, okay. What ran them out of the meta?
Dengar did a number on them. Zuckus actually did a number on Aces and small base high agility ships.
What does Zuckus do?
Basically, it's a 1-point version of R4B11.
Okay, that doesn't tell me anything.
So he would be able to...
You're speaking Latin. Tell me what it does.
He could take a stress, and for each stress he took, he can make you reroll a green dice.
Oh.
And the original wording of the card, he could do that. He could have as many stress as you wanted.
Oh.
So you built your build to around not care about ever doing actions.
Yeah, okay.
No, you didn't even... You just accepted the fact you're going to have stress.
You're
going to
have stress and stress forever.
And you just plan on never doing an action.
Dude, that's like drinking too much coffee. Stress forever.
It kind of... Boy. This was a long game without a whole lot of damage being done.
I mean, I remember I was playing behind you, and I remember hearing you... complaining, God damn it, I'm on an asteroid again. I can't get off this asteroid. What? Is this where he blocks you? I think this is where he bumps you.
I think
right?
the Falcon comes forward and blocks my next move.
I think he bumps you and keeps you on the mustache. You get another mustache ride. Woohoo!
No. Not okay.
It's not okay. Look, he placed that first and quick. He knew exactly. Good job, Aaron. He knew exactly what he was doing. He's going to bump you on the asteroid. That sounds like a sex move, right? Bump you. Hey, baby, I'm going to bump you on that asteroid. No, it doesn't sound like a sex move now. That just made it creepy.
Yeah, it did. Bump and grind on the asteroid, huh?
Bump and grind on the asteroid. I'll tell you what. If in my lifetime we ever make it out of space, I'm going to do asteroid bar. Got to do a bar and asteroid and an oxygen bubble. Why do you come to the asteroid? Oh, even better. Comet bar. So it only comes around your planet once every 100 years? And it would go around multiple planets? And you're guaranteed, it's like Prince's song, 1999, you're guaranteed a packed house. Every planet you pass. High dollar amount, because you only fit so many people. Right? Asteroid Bar, not Asteroid, Comet Bar, Comet Bar, with its sister cousin, Asteroid Bar. Because why would you fly to an asteroid field? The bar. Well, because there's no laws.
No, that's
there's
where the miners hang out.
Oh, asteroid miners. Oh, God, he totally blocked you. Look at that. That's beautiful. Aaron, that's a beautiful move. You should buy your wife extra Swedish meatballs at IKEA for that move. Is it? I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Kevin. I know this actually... This is the point where the game turned, right here.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is where things went.
Aaron, extra Swedish meatballs for your wife, because that was move super plus.
I think I made a miscalculation what I did with IG, and he didn't get to shoot either.
Oh, you did a whole round no shooting, and you're in range two? Oh no. Does IG have an arc, or is it 360?
It's arc.
Oh. You're not used to flying arcs that much, are you?
No, I'm not used to how where big base is set. Look at it. I'm on the corner of that asteroid. They just flew by.
I mainly fly see big that? Base. Oh no, double asteroid! Two ships, one cup. Oh my God! You landed on the asteroid. You got. This is why you were yelling. I was behind you playing a game. And every fourth word was asteroid.
That's just the square word of X-Wing, right?
Oh, my goodness. Asteroid. Still PG-13, folks.
Ish.
Ish. All right, so what's happening here? He gets full on range one. No, you bumped him, so he doesn't get to fire. But he does get to fire upon his... backward asteroid brother. What is he's not an arc with the other one. Okay, so it could have been worse. He could have had three ships fire on you. So did you go to time here?
I don't think I did.
Because we've been talking a lot of crap. I thought you might be going to time on this one.
The A-Wing comes around and shoots me in the butthole.
Yeah, good flying. And I think Aaron, that's good flying.
I think Wedge came around too and got a good shot on.
Well, I would assume so. If I were him, I would do like a three easy. Right? There's no asteroid. Yeah, three easy would be just perfect. That would mean he'd get two shots with his two small ships and the Falcon fires on your
the aggressor.
On your IG-88.
That's tokenless.
That's tokenless because he landed on the asteroid.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens.
This is an amazing turn to be Aaron. And a horrible turn to be me.
Sorry about your luck.
It happens.
Oh, he did two easy. Okay, so three easy, yeah.
Is it a two
easy.
Or a one? I think it's a one.
No, that was a two easy.
Was it a two?
Yeah, I think he's right. Three easy would have put him too much out of the range, but still, he gets a range two, range one on IG-88, I think, right?
Yep. It's only three dice because of IG. Yeah. So, you know. Welcome to Ow.
Welcome to Ow. Please, sir, can I have another?
Right. And now, do we have some dials?
Aaron flew really well this game. Holy crap.
He did.
And the great thing is, what I can see it's happening, is he's now going to pull off, I think, if I were him, he's pulling off with his Millennium Falcon to do, like, range hits. And he's going in for the kill with his small ships, because now they're there, right? And he's behind Dengar. Oh, okay, I know you're serious. Both hands are on the table. Look at that. Boom. You just move forward. Roll for your damage and no action. Kiss the Falcon.
Right. I mean, Dengar's on the asteroid, so. Shite.
Yeah. You know.
I should have done a 3D bank or something.
You know you're playing serious because both your hands are on the table. Look at that. Every time. If it's casual, you know you're doing good, it's fine. If you're serious, both your hands are on the table, so. Oh, damn. Did you just get hit again for being on the asteroid? Two? You did.
Yep.
Twice in a row. Oh, that's unfortunate. Can Dengar fire? Is he 360?
Yes.
So, yeah, he's got fire capabilities, but he's got... That's Jake, right?
Yes, Jake Furl's right.
Okay, but that's three defense dice. I would go against Wedge.
I don't...
Which one did... Because he's got two defense dice. Even though you get the extra one, that extra defense dice seems to be horrible. This is what I've noticed, is it's really hard to resist firing at someone at range one. But sometimes that's not the right choice, right?
Right.
It's really hard to say, no, I know the ship is at range one, but I stand a better chance at damaging this other ship who's at range two.
That's him shooting at me.
But he's got Predator, right? So he rerolled one. Oh, is that three hits?
He has initiative. Wedge shoots first.
Three hits.
But I only get one agility die.
Oh, because Wedge is firing against you, against Dengar. Oh, that's bam, bam. Thank you, ma'am. Oh, no.
Okay. Got a crit.
Remember, every time you do a crit, hang it up, put it in front of the camera. Sorry.
Ooh.
So we don't know what crit you have. It's mystery crit.
No, I know what crit I have.
What crit do you have?
Look how much damage you just took.
Oh, double damage. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so...
Jake could erase him.
Nine. So two of your damage were for asteroids.
Yep.
And he still has a range one shot, right?
Landing on the asteroid really hurt me.
Now,
Dengar can't shoot me.
No.
He's a rock, remember?
No, that's true. That's none. You get no shots.
Yeah.
Aaron's blocking move with you on the asteroid is just amazing. That's the game clincher right there.
Yeah.
Dengar go down this turn? I think he might.
I think Jake may have taken.
Oh, he did. He did two crits on you. Oh. That hurts bad.
And I pick up all the tokens and then I pick up my ship.
Oh, hi, Dengar. You didn't even get the fire back. I'm sorry. No revenge for you.
Note, Dengar's been switched out for Teltrevor in his list.
But with what?
Teltrevor.
What's Teltrevor do?
When you take lethal damage...
When
you get to damage would kill the ship.
Oh.
You remove all the damage cards and deal 4 face down damage cards.
Oh, that's crazy. Are you sure that's better than the fireback?
In my experience, the fireback has not procced. And it's less points, so
really? I've had fireback kill me. Oh, but that was the guy that was cheating and didn't do it once per round. He did it every attack.
Even when because
I was new.
Because of the way this list is set up, there's not, like, Untani Mind Link, which gives Dengar a bunch of extra tokens.
Yeah.
So when you get that fire back, it kind of falls flat.
Oh.
Because it's normally straight dice with me.
Oh. So, but yeah, if you had the focus with the fire back.
If I had an extra focus or an extra target lock or something with, like, a Dengaroo list, then it would make sense.
Yeah. I've been... A lot of people find it hard not to do Dengaroo because it's so powerful. But come on, fly something else.
Well, from the nerf, it's really almost nerfed it out of existence.
What did the nerf do to it? Because that was
Manaroo's abilities only works at range one.
Range one. Oh, so the ability to share. Oh, because Manaroo could go around the outside of the board, and it's like
she'd still be able to use her ability.
Even your range six.
A Tawny Mind Link is still unlimited range. But Manaroo's specific ability is not.
Okay. I didn't realize that. Because I don't fly scum, so I just kind of ignore those rules. And they're errata.
And Zuckus.
Okay, look how serious you are. Two hands on the table. You're serious. Why so serious?
I was trying to win this somehow.
With one chip?
I can do it.
Against three?
It's IG. Outer Rim Smuggler is a giant freaking blocker.
Yeah, well,
he's not a terribly aggressive ship. He's a lot to take down.
See, yeah,
but if I can get it down to just Outer Rim Smuggler,
yeah,
he's done. He can. I can beat him.
Well, that's what I did when I played him. But you guys will see that later. But my goodness, Aaron's flying like expert pilot skill plus plus.
Wedge.
So do you think Outer Rim Smuggler is going to do a K turn here? I would if I were him.
I don't think he does. I think he just brings him out and around.
Well, he does have three ships. Even if you were to give one up, you didn't even get half damage on the big. Oh my God! You haven't done
any damage.
Oh my God! He beat you down.
He did.
Who did he play next? You remember?
Aaron. Didn't he play you in the last match?
That's the last. Oh, there was only did three. So yeah, he played me in the last match.
Just to so you guys know what's going on, is normally we have, since we've been videoing the tournaments, we've had about 12, 14 players,
which is four rounds.
At least four rounds. This tournament, there was another tournament in
Colorado Springs, huge one,
where they were giving away a pre-sale to the Sea Rock.
Really?
Yep. Which is why a lot of people went to that.
Oh, because they were going to get Sea Rock before anybody and could play the cards before anybody.
Well, they get it when it releases, as soon as they get the ship. And that's a pretty good size price, you know.
And if you're into X-Wing, driving an hour and having lunch in a strange city is kind of fun, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's see what happens here.
And you've got to notice, X-Wing players are not young kids that don't go anywhere.
Well, that's the weird thing here about this, is this is not a cheap game.
No, so it really isn't.
Unlike Magic and some of the other ones where you have a lot of younger folk in it. But Magic's not cheap either, so I don't understand that.
So
this seems to be older folk.
Magic is weird because Magic seems cheaper, but to actually be competitive at Magic is much more expensive than to be competitive at X-Wing.
Yeah.
You know, your really good squads, to get all of the cards and stuff involved in them, even if you were to buy them MSRP, which a lot of people don't, you're still looking at $200-$300.
Yeah, which if you do, you can do a squad. You'll have to borrow someone's damage deck and maneuver templates. You can do a squad that can compete for $40 or so right here, $40 to $60, maybe $60.
Well, I mean, if you want to get the ideal cards to be like a tier one list.
No, I'm talking about X-Wing.
But yeah, like in X-Wing, if you want to be a tier one,
well,
$200, you're there.
Well, but
not 700 like a tier one Magic deck.
I know, but yeah, if you were to play in local tournaments and have a good time.
Yeah,
and
you can pick up the Heroes of the Resistance pack.
Which is Poe Dameron and
the New Falcon.
The New Falcon. You can run just
and
that.
That is
with the cards in it.
That is
completely
playable.
You don't have the maneuver dials.
Okay, so 80. So you go pick up the blue starter.
Well, or what I saw online, it's $10 for the damage deck on eBay, and $5 for the maneuver dials. So now you're talking. How much is the Heroes of the Resistance?
40.
So 50. For $55, you can have an awesome build that can win some games against people.
Yeah, I mean, even a full MSRP of $80, I mean, you're done. You can play that, and it's a viable game.
Yeah, getting the base set's good. Base set and Heroes of Resistance, $80, and you're done.
Yeah, I mean, you add like an A-Wing, so you get a push to limit in there.
Or just, if you're playing local folks, just print it out on your color printer, and there you go. Or buy it individually. Push the Limit's only like $3 on eBay.
Well, yeah, because right now. Push the Limit has been, well, it's been released as a tournament prize, as a one of the bulk cards they give away. Okay. It's also been released as,
it's been in a couple.
It's
ships.
Been in several ships.
Okay.
It's also been in. It was like in the. There was two copies of it in the Imperial Aces. It's in the A-Wings.
So I haven't really used it. I tend to go for expertise instead of personal.
It's also one of those cards that slipped out of, like, auto-include on the level list. My phone.
Yeah, because it seems like for you it's auto-include and motionless. At least one ship you're doing push the level, yeah. Right? So, but it doesn't make sense in the one I'm doing, like with Whisper.
No, you don't want stress.
You have to have something that can take stress or shed off stress or doesn't care about the action or can do green like crazy to get rid of it the next
time.
Well,
expertise has stepped up and competed with push the limit on a lot of ships. Mm. And a lot of ships that just don't have a green heart, enough green maneuvers. Generally speaking, I don't like running push the limit on anything.
Look at that. He's range one, four dice.
Yeah.
Target locking your butt. Look at that.
And I'm out of arc.
And you're out of arc. Oh my God. Is that four hits? That's four hits. Oh, three hits. That's
but I have a hits. Focus of eight on it. I knew I wasn't going to get a
oh,
shot.
Oh, he, no, he's doing Predator. He didn't do it because he didn't have a focus. You only get two defense?
What because of Wedge.
Oh, Wedge. Oh,
Wedge
geez.
Is a fucking jerk.
Oh, okay. You're spending the focus, and so you've got one of eight or two of eight. Oh, you're still pristine with IG-88, though. IG-88A.
Yeah, IG.
Did you take out anyone? Oh, you still haven't hit him yet. Dude, you still haven't hit him.
No, I think if I remember correct, I did like a sloop. And electronic baffled and was able to do three damage to the A-Wing in one shot. Problem is, I don't think I ever got the last point in on him. But.
What? Who's shooting at who?
I think that's the A-Wing shooting at me.
I guess you are an arc. Okay.
Yeah. Any predators?
Well, I hope
the
A-Wing does a one hard. Otherwise, he's going to run into an asteroid. Defense, you got three defense.
Spend the evade token. I'm good. 15. And now he's measuring for range on the
Millennium.
Which is at range three, so I have four defense dice.
Yep.
Yet, I'm out of tokens at this point, but I have four defense dice.
Yep.
And it auto thrusters.
Oh, out of arc. Yep.
So he only has two attack dice.
Look how serious you are. Two hands. And you have
because the Outer Rim Smuggler, he only gets two attack dice.
Oh, he does.
Gets four defense dice defense plus four. Auto thrusters.
Oh, no, you didn't do four. Look at you. You didn't do four.
Oh, there's another one hiding by my hand.
Oh, there it is. Okay.
I had. So it didn't matter. I had one of eight.
Okay.
I think I actually had to auto thruster that. Okay, there's a reason you put all the dang cards in there.
Yeah.
I was surprised Wedge didn't get a damage on me. But because Wedge shoots first, I had all my tokens.
Oh.
So it was like, eh. Yeah. IG-88, when ran correctly, can be a real pain in the butt to get damage in on.
Right, but where do you go from here? Now all of your turns are either into an asteroid or nowhere, and you're going to be out of arc, and no one's shooting anything. Sorry, that was my karaoke.
And I have a stress.
And you have a stress.
My biggest mistake...
You can't do a K-turn.
I should have electronic baffles to keep that stress off.
Yeah, you should have, because you got full.
Because if I had electronic baffled, then I would have been able to K turn and get a shot.
But it's three little bears against Goldilocks is what happened. You got scared. I don't want to lose a shield. I might get hit. But yeah, you needed a K turn at this point, or
I needed to get back into the fight.
You need to get back in the fight. How do you get back in the fight from here? Now that all of your children are grown up. Okay, sorry.
I think it's what I did. I green three bank or something. To clear that stress, and then I push the limit, but I electron baffled it. And then I do a K turn, but...
Yeah, you should have electronic baffled it.
I should have at that point. Yeah, I made there's a lot of what not to do in this video me.
That's the whole reason for this, is we get to do Monday quarterbacking, right, on the Sunday games?
On ourselves.
Yeah, on ourselves. Well, that's good. That's how we learn. It's like therapy.
One thing I've noticed about this list is it's not, I'm not sure if it's good or bad.
I don't know, even know where to start with that. I'm not sure about this list. I don't know if it's good or bad. Of course you know if it's good or bad.
No, I don't.
What does that mean?
Because I played it so freaking poorly, and I've noticed every time I play it, I make decisions that were not correct. So it's like, if I can figure out how to play it, I think it might actually do fairly well.
Well, how about this? How about thinking up a list that actually counters poor decisions? There's such a thing? There's the new meta. Here's a list that prevents me from making poor decisions.
There used to be. It was called Palpatine.
Oh, yeah. Well, if you can remember to use Palp, and we know people who forget to use Palpatine.
Oh.
That's just bad. Oh, my God. He almost flew off.
But, yeah, I mean, Palpatine used to be it just solved your bad dice rolls and bad decisions.
Bad flying and bad decisions. So it's the morning after pill for X-Wing.
Well, also the Defenders, with an X7 title, used to be you could do whatever and shove them in all kinds of stupid spots, still get your evade token, and still keep them on the board. But now you got to actually fly to darn things.
I don't know. I'm going back to expertise. It's my favorite card to put in a build. Do you think they're going to errata that?
No, I don't. I think expertise is balanced quite well.
Really? Okay. Because, well, there's those builds where they give stress out. If I were to go up against the build that gave stress out, I would be hosed. My build would not work.
That's completely the thing, is if you run up against a build with expertise that's all about throwing down stress on the table, it's going to screw you.
Yeah, yeah. I haven't played against that build. So, you know, folks who play at Chep's, do a stress build and you can take me down in 5 moves or less. Oh, how did you do? Are you flipped around? No, you're not flipped around. That's the weird thing about your ship is I'm...
you can't tell which way it's going.
I can't tell which way it's pointing because it looks like a goddamn crab. Right? All of a sudden, I want to dip you in butter and suck your legs out.
It's a robot.
Oh, it is a robot, yeah. Because so it doesn't need to be... doesn't have to have oxygen. There you go.
No, he doesn't. Well, those are the assassin droids, remember?
Yeah, but we've talked about it. You know, that's why Star Wars is totally ridiculous. You would never have human pilots. It'd be all drones and be the battle of the algorithms, right?
So
who could code the best algorithm? But the Force makes you...
So the interesting thing is the technology in Star Wars is kind of bizarre.
Well, yeah, yeah. Well, so, you don't go to a science fiction movie looking for... realism. You're just looking for internal consistency. So.
One of the funny things about Star Wars, the genre, is warp drive was given to the people. It wasn't created by the people.
Who gave it to the people? Is this something that's in the?
It is in canon.
Really?
George Lucas mentioned that angels were extra-dimensional beings that gave them warp drive. So they weren't... they weren't as technologically advanced as they appear to be.
So apparently warp drives result from unicorn farts from angels? Is that what happens? That's ridiculous. Angels.
But,
angels.
But,
is he serious? How much drugs was he on when he said angels... By the way, new announcement, angels are in canon. You can proceed.
What? Yeah.
Angels.
Yeah. But there are... So there's a really strange Rebels episode where they actually have these space whales that go to warp.
Space what?
I don't know what the heck they're actually called, but they look like whales.
Whales. Oh, so the angel blessed the whale's anus so he could poop out unicorn farts and go to warp. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, George.
We'll go with that.
Thank you, George Lucas, yet again. Space whales, my ass.
Space opera. Gotta love it.
Well, yeah. Well, what do space whales eat?
The same thing that you run your ships on.
Yeah, but if they have mouths, why do they have mouths then?
I got to show you that episode.
Okay, I haven't seen... Guys, I haven't seen any of the... I've seen very few. Probably the first 4 episodes.
It's also where the
animated series.
It's also where the scum TIE fighter's going to come from.
Okay, so you're gonna drive a Scum TIE fighter up a whale. But then does that mean every time they go to warp they see God? That's why all the trails are there? What type of drugs was that man on? Angels.
Hey, look at IG's health now.
Ooh, you're getting pounded.
It's not good.
You have double target locks on you.
Yep. And they stayed. That's the worst part. He rolled good enough dice, he didn't need anything. Oh, wow. And I have 3 health.
Well, that's what happens when your wife goes to IKEA. You roll good dice.
Apparently. Just send your wife to IKEA before the tournament. You'll be good.
Yeah, you'll be good. Because you're doing a good thing.
For the Swedish.
Yeah, I actually saw a friend of mine did a Facebook post. He was hungry for meatballs, and so they live close to IKEA, and so they drove in the parking lot, and his wife said, "I'll be back in a minute," and he set a timer, and it was actually an hour and a half later before she showed back up, and all he wanted her to do was go in and get meatballs. Hour and a half later, she did come back with the meatballs, nothing else, but it was an hour and a half.
Gotta love IKEA, man.
Sorry, guys. We haven't been really talking about this game that much. That's because...
It went horribly.
Kevin, it's a bad dream. It's a nightmare. He has fever in the middle of the night. And,
oh, come on. It's not that bad.
And yells out, "Out of him, smuggler! Don't hit me again!" No, I'm just kidding.
No, but, I mean, seriously, if you want a big base blocker and you're playing Rebels... And a Rim Smuggler might not be a bad option.
Yeah, this is the first time I've seen a Millennium Falcon with two other ships. Usually it's a Millennium Falcon with another Millennium Falcon, or a Millennium Falcon with one small base. I mean, I haven't seen a three-ship build with a Millennium Falcon in a bit, so...
It's 27 points. And it only has 2 crew slots.
27 points. Well, Wedge should have the proton torpedoes? Is there something else he could do?
Would Wedge?
Yeah. Or does he not have a slot, and that's why he chose proton torpedoes? Does he have
any... No, I think proton torpedoes is perfectly fine on Wedge.
He has an EPT. Well, but he doesn't have a... what's it with the two wrenches crossing? Was it modification?
No, he doesn't.
Would a modification suit him better than the proton torpedo? What modification could he have? Is expertise an EPT? It's got to be an EPT.
It's
right?
an EPT, okay. But it might be better than proton predator. I don't know. Proton torpedoes are really good. I'm not a huge fan of proton torpedoes.
I think expertise would be better than predator, in my opinion. Because you get to roll one dice, instead you get a free focus on attack. I would go for that.
Yeah.
That would beef that dude up like crazy.
Well, I mean, he could have run expertise on Jake and...
Oh, that's on, true. He didn't
him
need Predator.
And Biston.
Well,
and not
I
really
kind of like Biston because he looks like a potato.
He's a really furry potato.
Well, yeah, but that's a potato that you've set too long and it's growing the roots out and it's about to... Anyway, I was thinking of Doctor Who about the potato.
So I managed to get turned around?
Yeah, I think you get one shot. You said you did. Right now, you haven't done a single point of damage, Kevin. What are you doing with your life?
Not winning this game. That's what I'm doing. I'm not winning. I boosted it, by the way.
Good for you. Which did that result in you doing damage?
Not freaking help, apparently.
No.
No. Well, the A-Wing doesn't get to shoot.
Yeah, but neither do you on anything.
I don't know. Oh, yeah, no. But I did arc dodge him, so I think the only thing that's going to get...
No, you didn't arc dodge him. He arc dodged you. Oh, what's he doing? He's
doing
pushing the limit.
He's doing a boost, but he's behind me, so he's not going to work.
Yeah.
I think...
He's planning for next move. No shots, or is there a 3 for the Outer Rim Smuggler?
Electronic baffling when you only have... No, I don't want that.
God, he's got a barrel roll. Does he have barrel roll on that one?
When he does a green maneuver, he can... BB-8
is that a
can
green?
Barrel roll.
Is that a green maneuver? I think he should
I
barrel roll.
I think a 3 straight is.
Oh, geez. If he barrel rolls, then you're an arc.
Yep. And Wedge is not. That's bad news.
Let's see if he remembers. He doesn't. Yeah, he should have barreled.
I think he barreled.
Is three a green for him? I don't know.
Good question. I was thinking it was, but I'm not super familiar with the T70's dial.
Yeah, neither am I. I've played it once.
The T65? Do you even own a T65? Do you have the red corset?
No, I don't. Then I don't have it. Sorry, I thought you said a 70. Arc 70. I don't have Arc 70.
You have the Arc 170, yeah.
Yeah, I have the Arc 170, sorry. No, I don't have the red corset, and I think that's going to get more expensive as the years go on, because they're not going to produce it anymore. Maybe they'll re-release some of the ships.
It's on the list to be reprinted.
Oh, it is? Just for the ships? Oh, God, that's expensive just to get those ships? Oh, I don't know if I want to do that.
What? Oh. No, three destroyers not green.
Oh, that's why he couldn't barrel. Okay. What's green on him? Two forward and two turns and ones?
No, one turns. One banks. And one straight, two straight.
All right, so Outer Rim Smuggler is the only one that has a shot.
No, that's the challenge with the T-65s.
Oh, we got two blanks. That's unfortunate. All right, back to dials. I'm sorry I'm quoting that other podcast, Back to Dials, but it's such a catchy phrase. Good job, guys. We haven't named this podcast. I don't think we will. Just Sheps. Sheps Podcast. I don't know.
Just Sheps. Ships.
Sheps.
Sheps. Ships.
S squared. There we go. S squared.
S squared.
S ships. Put in the comments if you have a idea for what we should name this podcast,
or what we should name our tournament coverage.
Tournament coverage, yeah. Not pod. We're not doing a podcast
yet.
We're yet. I mean, terrible? I need to sleep sometime. You know, Kevin. It's between playing X-Wing and commenting it. I mean, what days am I not doing X-Wing stuff? Oh, well, that sounds like a beautiful life, actually.
He's addicted.
Yeah.
It could be a lot worse.
It could be a lot worse. We could be that old man. We could be Bill.
You know what the funny thing is?
Bill is the guy, you've probably seen him on him before, he's retired. That man spends money hand over fist on this.
Do you know what the funny thing about that is?
Multiple things.
I've talked to Bill, and he's like, yeah, I quit smoking. And took all the money it was spending on cigarettes, started spending it on X-Wing.
On X-Wing. Well, there you go.
And he's well over $5,000 worth of ships.
Well, maybe I should do that with pizza. Stop ordering pizza and order more X-Wing. I mean, you think about it. You order a couple pizzas, it's $18, $20. That'll buy me some goddamn X-Wing, won't it?
Yes.
All right. Hey, that's our new slogan. No pizza, more X-Wing. All right, let's see. I'm sorry, we've not been talking about the game, but... Oh, Kevin, you haven't done any damage. It's so sad.
No, Aaron did really good on this round. Yeah. And I did.
He's done some amazing flying. His two smaller ships are going to be right up your butt in just a second. And they're both probably going to be at range one.
I should have worked my electronic baffles earlier.
Yeah.
Because electronic baffles is the tool that lets me get back into the fight with IG, and I just...
Yeah, because you can electronic baffle PTL K-turn Jesus.
K-turn Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I don't know if you've seen the aggressor's dial.
No.
But all the banks and straights from 1 to 3 are green.
Oh, really? Wow.
It's got a one bank, two bank, three bank.
Oh, it's
both sides green.
Well, because it's a robot. He knows how to turn. It's his bread and butter.
He doesn't do hard turns green.
Oh.
None of his hard turns are green.
That's fine, though.
Nine green maneuvers to choose from.
That is crazy talk right there.
And he has a three salute.
That is
Shred.
Kind of powerful. Yeah, it is. Yeah, but if you can shed it with electronic baffles, then there you go.
As I've learned, that's
the thing to do. Why didn't you sloop or K-turn?
I did. I just did. I waited too late to do it.
Goodness. You did it on this. You didn't do it on this turn.
I did on the next turn. Believe it or not, I lived through this turn.
Really? I wouldn't have thought you would have lived through this turn.
I think Danielle's.
You've got two target locks.
Yeah, target locks aren't that scary.
Really? Well, I don't know. Target locks with expertise are deadly.
Well, yeah, because you don't have a use for the focus token.
No. Why focus when you can target lock with...
Well, I've actually heard Dallas Parker said this. Expertise to him is a defensive upgrade because you can keep the focus token for defense every time.
Oh, that's true. Oh, that's a good way to look at it. That's a really good way to look at it. You totally increase... Oh, gosh, yeah, that's really good.
Because you're never going to use it.
You're never going to use it.
Unless you got weapons guidance, which most people don't run.
No. One hit.
But dear God.
Oh, he target locked. Two hits. Oh, he's using his target lock. Two hits. Two hits or three hits?
I'd say you should run Poe.
With expertise?
Expertise weapons guidance. R2-D2.
Ooh. Go in, do some damage.
You want weapons guidances, right?
No, I don't.
Changes a blink to a hit.
Oh.
By spending a focus token.
Oh, so if you have expertise and weapons guidance, bam-blam.
Yes, but Poe Dameron is not the guy you really want that on because of his palatability.
But
you could run it on any other T-70, it would be good.
You know, that means you take focus for defense and because you don't need to take target lock because that's really...
Well, there's evil. a tech card. There's two of them. There's one that allows you to spend a focus, change a blank to a hit, which is weapons. I think it's weapons guidance. But there's a tech card that does that for 2 points.
Uh-huh.
And there's another 2-point tech card that lets you change a blank defense die to an evade.
Ah. And if you have focus on top of it, yeah, we need to think about a build with that.
Well, you spend the focus to change to get
that hit. Is that faction specific?
No, it's a tech slot.
Oh.
Which means it's basically the first order stuff.
Oh, okay.
Which the T-70s, the U-Wing, the Kylo Ren shuttle.
Ooh, Kylo Ren shuttle with that setup?
It can fit both of them.
Oh, geez, that is evil.
It has two tech slots.
Ooh, that's evil. I don't think you set down this whole match, right? You're standing.
No, I was worried about this match and for good reason. But I did some awful flying early on when she took Dengar out.
Yeah.
It just wasn't okay. And Aaron's on point this match. You know, the problem is I've got tools to answer a lot of the situations I got myself into. And I realized it in hindsight after the match, looking back at it. And I realized that at this point in the match, I had some answers, but I didn't use them early enough.
So what? Who'd you play for your final match on this one?
Steven.
Okay. How'd you do against his super tough? Well, you were Manaru, or you were Dengar against Dengar, right, or whatever.
No, I think I played my first match. I don't remember who I played.
Who did you play in your last match? You played him on your first one.
I think I beat him on my first match.
Well, you guys went to time, right?
We did, and then it came down to points. By the way, I finally slooped.
There you go. Woohoo!
And I had electronic baffle.
Oh my gosh, you have one left. But you can't... Oh, did you take a...
I electronic baffled to clear the stress from the sloop.
Oh, so you took a hole?
Oh. I took a hole. I was like, you know what? Hail Mary. Let's see what happens.
At least take one ship out. With what?
I didn't succeed at killing a ship. I put Farrell at one health.
Well, that explains why I usually you go at least... You take a couple ships out. This is why I played Aaron in the last round then, because...
Yeah.
Lord Jesus, what happened?
It's a new build, and there's just a lot of intricacies to it that I'm still trying to work out how to deal with. But I... So I took this build to...
I would blame it on the robot.
I took this build to a Wednesday night tournament at Wizard's Chess and got
in
my
downtown
face
Denver.
Owned.
Oh, you did?
And then I played, and I won... I think I won one match, and then I got really close on another match with this same build. And I've tweaked the list to where I'm kind of tuning it, trying to get to where I think it makes sense.
Yeah, the guys at the Wizard's Chest are really good. So so this is we're recording this on Easter Sunday, April 2017. 2 weeks, there's the X-Wing for Cancer event at the Wizard's Chest, which we'll be at. So we'll see how these builds do. I think I'm going to run the same build that I did this time, just so people can go ooh and awe. Because I did a modification to my Whisperer, and
yep.
It's got a reed switch and a magnet and an LED, and if you put the cloak on it, lights up blue. So even if I lose, people can go, woo!
Pretty shit.
Yeah, and then I got to do another build. So I played it. My rule is 3 tournaments, and I need to change the build. Otherwise, you get in a rut. This will be the 3rd tournament, and I gotta. Actually, it'll be the second tournament. But I've been playing it for a month now. You got to play other ships, because otherwise, if you don't, then you don't get thinking about other builds and other possibilities, right?
Well, you can
plus,
always,
it's just fun to play other ships.
You can play other ships to make videos too. You don't have to play them in tournaments.
Well, that's true, but then we'd have to. Then we'd have to do this on every single match we play. We're not gonna film everyone we do.
No. One thing I had been considering, and I've talked to Ben about this, that we'll probably do in the future, is there'll probably be 2 videos.
Ooh, 3 hits. I think you hit here.
On our off weeks.
Uh-huh.
Where we'll actually play them and commentate them during our play.
Oh, yeah, because we can play them outside. The reason why you don't see audio and we do commentary afterwards is there's a room full of people. All the talking, you wouldn't be able to hear us.
Yeah,
we're not isolated. It's not set up like in some of the places where they have a separate room for their filming. We're out on the floor here. There's 20 people. There's 6 people playing X-Wing and 10 people playing Magic. And
yep.
I think Danielle was demoing a game too.
Yep.
So you're not going to hear anything. But you're right. Off weeks, we'll play and comment real time.
Well, what we're thinking about doing is doing a go through the waves one by one.
Oh, yeah.
From the beginning.
Just play wave one ships. Yeah, Danielle had that idea.
So what I'm thinking this is going to look like is one match of... By the way, look at Jake.
Yeah.
That's one round of shooting for me.
Oh, well, you had 3...
I did some damage.
Yeah, he had no defense, and you had 3 hit dice. They're still on the table on the right-hand side. Hit, hit, hit.
I punched it through.
Yep, and you were hoping for one more. That's why you took the stress.
I was hoping to get a crit and get a double and just knock him down, but it didn't happen.
It didn't happen. No half damage on Jake, though. That's a small base ship. Sorry.
Yeah, unfortunately. But I did get some damage in.
You did. Good job. You get a gold star.
I should have done it earlier. And if I would have slipped around, I would have broke up
his
formation.
Yeah, you should have electronic baffled and swooped way back then.
I should have. I waited way too long
to do
it.
And you definitely should have gone after Jake. Even though he has 3 defense dice.
The problem is I need to be PTLing so I have enough tokens to defend against this mess. So I have to rely on...
Well, I think losing Dengar so early kind of shook you because you were going after Outer Rim Smuggler to begin with.
Yep.
And then after you lost Dengar, you broke off. You went to the right instead of the left. You didn't follow Outer Rim Smuggler.
Yeah.
And you should have followed Outer Rim Smuggler to get
even
though
Outer Rim Smuggler outturn IG. Well, sort of.
But still, he's only got 1 defense dice. You could have got half damage on him with how many turns you went through. You spent 4 turns flying without shooting. If you would have flown and gone after Outer Rim Smuggler.
Did I get a bumper? Well, he's not going to shoot me.
No, I mean, his dial's
the problem
go over
is
your base.
The A-Wing is not going to...
Oh, he's... Yeah, that one's not
The A-Wing's not going to get a shot, and I don't get a shot on the A-Wing.
Oh.
If I had electronic baffles, I could have suicided it and taken down the A-Wing with me. Which, to be downright honest with you, if I had had electronic baffles on the ship, I would have used electronic baffles to suicide and kill them both.
Oh, he moved in your arc. Oh, you're facing the other way.
Yeah. Oh. I did a K-turn.
Did a K-turn. All right, he's just getting closer, because why not? Kiss my lasers. Also,
it's going to be 4 dice, and I only get 2 defense, even with the 2 tokens.
And that's, he's got target lock, and he's taking focus.
Yep, that's all the mods.
No, he just had target lock.
Because he had used it. Is it range 1? I think it is.
Yeah. A moment of silence for IG-88. Thank you.
Hey, I sit down.
You do sit down. You know,
I know it's over at this point.
Finally, you were standing up the whole time, and now you've sat down.
Well, at this point, I know the match is over. It's done. I've lost. I've got 1 health. There's no coming back from
that. Something happened.
I mean, I'm not going to kill Wedge. Wedge is going to push a point through, and I'm dead.
Yeah, no. I thought he was doing a bad flying with Wedge. With Jake, but he got him out of your arc, which
saved him.
Points. Yeah, and this is basically a 200-point match for Aaron. I mean, 100 points for winning the match, and he did 100 points. He was going to remove all your ships, and you do nothing. So that's very powerful. Especially in a tournament with only 3 rounds, if you get a 200-point round,
yep.
I mean, you're in the final table, or at least in the top 3, guaranteed there. Or at least in the running for the top 3. So.
Oh. Did I survive Wedge? It did, apparently.
What?
Did I?
No. I think the video stopped. Did the video stop? Yep. I think you died.
No.
Glitchy. Oh, maybe you were just freeze frame.
I'm just really... No, he didn't kill me.
That's really weird. We weren't paying attention. Sorry, guys, we're off script today. Or maybe we're on script. Maybe the side commentary is the real reason you listen to this podcast. I would hope so, because, you know, it's only have so much commentary flying ships. Okay, he rolled 3 hits. Let's see what the defense is.
And that's the reason I don't like doing live commentary, because it seems to be what it sounds like.
Oh, yeah. I see how it is. We'll see how it goes when we do the first one for Wave 1, which I don't own any Wave 1 ship, so I'm going to borrow some.
You have
some.
A T-65?
Oh, I do. I did. That's Wave 1?
I don't think you have a Y-Wing.
Okay.
So Imperials was the TIE Fighter?
Uh-huh.
TIE Advanced.
Okay. I have a TIE Advance, yep.
That's it. That's 2.
Okay.
And then the X-Wing, the original one.
Uh-huh.
And the Y-Wing. And that's it.
That's it. So we're going to swarm it, basically,
that,
right?
That's basically...
Swarm against swarm.
That's basically the beginning of Wave 1, was those 4 ships were in the game.
That sounds kind of frustrating to fly. I'm surprised it caught on with that those ships.
Well, it had to start somewhere. It didn't stay there long. But, you know, at that point, TIE Swarms were kind of dominating.
Well, yeah, because that's all you had to choose from.
So one thing I want to do is a build of the Wave 1 ships as they were at the time.
Oh, with the...
With just the upgrades that were available.
Were available. That's fine. Well, we should do that.
And then a Wave with the same ships as you can build them today.
Yeah.
And where they sit today.
I love all these plans, but when are we ever going to sleep?
When you're dead.
Oh, well, yeah.
Sleep's sort of dead, right?
Well, does that
rest
mean,
in peace.
Does that mean you die when you sleep? I don't know. Okay, you focused.
Because
you're showing your butt to the entire fleet.
No, not really. Well, I don't know what he's going to do
with
the
A-Wing. Wedge. The A-Wing's coming. He's going to do, I'd say, a two easy. No, two hard. Two hard.
One hard.
One hard. What?
A-Wing. Got to love him. He's coming around. A-Wing has the best L in the game. By far. And then he's boosting. Mm-hmm. Because he took the focus.
Push the limit and parry roll?
I would hope he... But he can't barrel roll. He should have barrel rolled off his ability, then boosted. That would have got him around that rock.
Yeah. But he does have... No, he did. He's barrel rolling. He's pushing the limits and barrel rolling.
But he doesn't have a... He had to barrel roll off his ability.
He doesn't have barrel roll?
No.
Then he cheated.
But A-Wing's hat, I think it's because of that Jake's ability.
Oh, but he should have done that
when he
first.
Takes the focus token, he gets the barrel roll. So he pushed the limit to do the focus token, then he used Jake's ability to barrel
roll. To do the barrel roll, okay. But he boosted in between, though.
Yeah, boost was his first action.
Oh, boost was the first action. Push the limit for an evade to barrel roll. That's highly maneuverable. That's... I mean, you can get anywhere you want to be
That's
with those
Jake.
Things. That's crazy.
Jake is really good at getting... There's a reason that ship has stood the test of time.
Yeah, I mean, that's so maneuverable. It's ridiculous. Even he has...
Wedge is out of position here.
Yeah. He is. I didn't understand that one. But he's still going to get dice on two ships.
I don't think he... I thought I was going to come around like that.
You're using your evade to flip one of them?
I think it was use my focus.
Focus. I'm sorry. Why did I say evade? Focus.
I think it was the focus token I spent to change a eyeball to an evade. And I still have an evade token on it. Two hits. He used the focus token to make it three.
Three hits, and you get two defense. Three defense, right?
Three defense. Okay.
But you still have a focus. You're hoping.
I blinked.
That's it. It's done. Shake the hands.
I'm going to evade. Yeah, done. Yep.
Is it shake hands time? Ew. All right. Next one's the final match out of this short 3-set tournament. May the force be with you.